So, as discussed earlier, that the statement of law of conservation means what? Okay. So, it is given that sum of momentum of two objects before collision is equal to the sum of momentum after the collision, provided there is no external unbalanced force acting on them. Okay. So what does this mean? What does this statement mean? This statement means that if suppose there are two objects, say there are two balls, okay, there are two balls having mass m1 and m2, okay, having mass m1 and m2, right? If they are moving in the same direction, and say that let the initial velocity of first ball be u1 and for the second ball it be u2, and you have to just keep in mind that always we would be using u1 and u2 for expressing the initial velocity, okay? And if suppose u1 is more than u2, then of course these both are going to collide, okay? Means suppose they are colliding at some point, okay? So after colliding, the speeds are going to change, okay? So once they will collide, the speed will change, and they will again keep on moving with a new speed, and that speed would be v1 and v2. Okay, we are denoting the v1 and v2. This v1 and v2 are the final speeds. That is the final velocity, right? And they are still moving in the same direction. Okay. Like you might have seen that when an accident occurs, the body still moves after the accident for a few seconds with some other velocity. Okay, the speed changes. So this is v1 and v2. So you have to always keep in mind that u1 and u2 are initial velocities, and v1 and v2 are final velocities. And the mass is m1 for this one and m2 for the second body, right? Now, as we know that the momentum is calculated by multiplying the mass and velocity, okay? So if I want to calculate the momentum for this case, that is before collision, so how I can do that? I will write m1 u1, that is the momentum of first body, plus m2 u2, this is the momentum of second body, right? And we are adding them, so it becomes sum of the momentum of two objects before collision, okay? And according to the statement, it is equal to what? It is equal to the momentum after the collision. So if you want to write the momentum after the collision, it would be m1 v1, right? Then m2 v2. Understood? So this is going to be the mathematical form of this statement, right? And we will see a derivation to prove this relation, that initial momentum before collision is equal to final momentum after collision. And you have to learn this formula because it would be used in solving a lot of numericals based on this conservation of momentum. Okay, so is this clear to everyone how we got this formula? What is m1 u1 and all these things? Here is the derivation. So first of all, we have to suppose few things. So suppose that two objects, say A and B, and these are the two objects A and B, they are having mass m1 and m2, okay? They are traveling in the same direction along a straight line, okay? And they are having initial velocities, that is u1 and u2 respectively, means u1 is for A, u2 is for B, okay? And no other force is acting on them. Now suppose u1 is more than u2, means suppose it is 80 and it is 40, or it is 30. So of course u1 is going to hit u2, okay? So the moment when they will collide, they are going to apply force on each other, right? So the force applied by A on B is given by F of AB, means FAB, and the force by B on A is written by BA. Okay, you just have to remember like this. If you are writing AB, it means the force is applied from A on B. If you are writing BA, then force is applied by B on A. Just don't confuse in this. You have to, this should be clear. And then after collision, they will again move, but with some different velocity, that is V1 and V2. Okay. So I think the figure is clear to everyone, and the same figure you have to draw, right? And what you have to write over here, that let U1 and U2, let U1 be greater than U2, and two balls collide with each other as shown in the figure. Now, during collision, suppose a collision happens for time t. And because of this collision, the ball A exerts a force. Okay, the ball A is exerting a force on ball B, and that force is given by FAB. Okay, and similarly, according to third law of motion, even ball B will exert a force on ball A, and that force we are denoting it by FBA. Right, and once this force is applied, the velocity will change, and now the velocities are denoted by V1 and V2. V1 is for ball A, and V2 is for ball B. Okay? And these are the velocities after the collision. Right? Now we will write all the momentums. For object A, the initial momentum would be M1 U1. Right? The mass into its velocity. For object B, the initial momentum would be M2 U2, its mass and its velocity. Then the final momentum for object A, this M1 into V1, right? Mass into velocity. And similarly for object B, the final momentum would be M2 into V2. Okay, so we have got all the momentums. Initial momentum and final momentum of both ball A and B. Now, see, their velocities are going to change. And if the velocities are changing, of course, the momentum will change, because momentum depends on the velocities, right? So what is the change in momentum for both the balls? So as both the balls were colliding for time t, so after the collision, the change in their momentum can be written as, okay, now to write the change, we just have to subtract final minus initial, right? So this is the final momentum, this one of A, and this is the initial momentum of A, this one. Okay, so on subtracting the final momentum of A and initial momentum of A, we will get change in momentum of A, right? Similarly, to find the change in momentum of B, what we do, we have to subtract this M2 V2 minus M2 U2, that is final momentum minus initial momentum. Okay, so these two are the change in momentum, right? And we also know that during collision, both the balls have imparted force on each other. And the force on A was BA, and the force on B was AB. Okay. We have already studied in second law that the force is the rate of change of momentum upon time. So to find FAB, that is the force acting on ball B. Okay, we will write this one, M1 V1 minus M1 U1 upon time. Okay, and similarly, and from this we can just take out the M1 as common. We can take out M1 common, and the equation will become like this. Okay, so M1 bracket V1 minus U1 upon T. Okay, so this is the change in momentum, the upper part, that is the numerator, and upon T. So that is going to give us the force. Similarly for B, the rate of change of momentum in B was M2 V2 minus M2 U2. Okay, and this change in momentum upon T will give us the force F of BA. Okay, and even from this one, we can take out M2 common. So our equation will look like this, that M2 bracket V2 minus U2 upon T. It is very simple. We just have to divide the change in momentum by time T. That's it. So we got two equations. First off, F of AB, that is force acting on B, and F of BA, that is force acting on A, right? And according to Newton's third law of motion, we know that that both the forces, whenever two objects collide, the force acts on both the objects and they both are equal and in opposite direction, right? So we have to equate this one. If both are equal, so of course F of AB should be equal to F of BA. So we have written them in equal, and because the direction is opposite, here we can see the direction is opposite, right? And hence, to show that opposite direction, we have used this minus sign. We have used this minus sign. So what this negative sign is indicating? That the direction is opposite. Okay. Now, after writing this, that is F of AB equals to minus F of BA. After writing this, we just have to place the values. We have to place the values. Okay. Instead of, in place of F of AB, we will place this value, and in place PA, we will place this value, that is M2 V2 minus U2, right? Okay. Now, can we cancel this T and T? So, this T and T is going to cancel, right? Now, what is left out? Now, the upper part, we can multiply the brackets. So, if we are multiplying the brackets, so M1 will be multiplied by V1, it will give us M1 V1. Then, M1 will be multiplied by U1, it will give us M1. Similarly, M2 would be multiplied by V2. It will give us M2 V2. And there is V2. So it would be minus. Similarly, M2 into U2 will give us M2 U2. And this minus will become positive.
Plus.
Right? So the equation is looking like this. That M1 V1 minus M1 U1 equals to minus M2 V2 plus M2 U2, right? Now, as we know that in the formula that we have to derive, okay, there is no negative sign. So to change the negative sign, what we can do? We can shift them, right? If we will take this term on the other side of the equals to, it will become positive. And if this term on the other side, it will also become positive, right? See this, M2 V2 has been taken on the other side. So it is written over here. Okay. And this M1 U1 is written over here. That is on the other side of the equals to. So even the sign of that term has been changed to positive, right? So finally, what we got? We got this equation, that is M1 U1, sorry, M1 V1 plus M2 V2 equals to M1 U1 plus M2 U2. And as we have discussed earlier, that see M1 U1, U1 and U2 are the initial velocities, right? So this right hand term is giving us the total initial momentum, and here V1 and V2 were the final velocities. So this side term, that is the left hand side term, is giving us the final momentum. So it has been proved that initial momentum, total initial momentum, is always equal to final momentum. Okay, so this is how we have to write the derivation for this law of conservation of momentum. Okay, like in case of ball, we were taking two situations, that is before collision and after collision. So even here, we will take two situations, before firing and after firing. So before firing, if I will ask that what, this is a gunner. If I will ask that what is if before firing I'm asking that what is the speed or the velocity of gun and the bullet, so it would be zero because nothing is in motion, right? So what I can write, that suppose U1 is for gun and U2 is for, wait a minute, suppose U1 is for gun, velocity of gun, and U2 is the velocity of bullet. So both would be zero before before firing. Both are going to be zero, right? But after firing, wait a minute. See, I'm writing over here. Just see over here. It is see, we have two things. One, a gun and a bullet, right? Mass of bullet is 60 gram. So first we need to convert that into kg. So on dividing by 1000, we got it 0.0 kg. Okay. Now, because initially both are at rest before firing, both are at rest. So their velocities are going to be zero. Means U1 and U2 are going to be zero, right? So for bullet, we are using U1 and V1 is the velocity after firing. Similarly, U2 for gun and V2 is the velocity of the gun after firing, right? So it is given that after firing, the velocity of bullet is V1. Okay, means the bullet is going to move with a velocity of V1. Okay, and even the gun is going to face some recoil velocity. It is going to have some recoil velocity, and that velocity is V2. And that we have to find. It is given that what is the recoil velocity of the gun. And the mass of gun is 5 kg. That is the M2. It is 5 kg. Okay. Now, next what we have to do, we have to apply the law of conservation of momentum. Okay. So we know that initial momentum is equals to final momentum. Okay, right? Initial momentum is equals to final momentum. So the formula is m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. That last derivation, whatever we have derived, that we have to write. m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Right. Now we just have to keep all the values. So what is the value of u1? Zero. Value of u2? Zero. So LHS is going to be zero. Whole LHS is going to be zero because U1 and U2 are zero. Hence, I have written a single zero over here. Okay. Now on this side, value of M1, that is 0.06. Value of V1, 500. Value of M2, that is of gun, 5. And V2, we doesn't know. Okay. So on doing the calculation, this 500 into 0.06 will give us 30. And if we take that 30 on the other side of the equals to, it will become negative, right? Then on 5, dividing 30 by 5, we will get minus 6. So V2 is minus 6. Now there is minus. What does this minus sign indicates? This minus sign indicates that the direction in which the gun is moving or the pistol is moving is in the opposite direction of the bullet. Okay, like we have seen that if bullet is moving in this direction, so of course the gun is going to move in the opposite direction. Okay, and this opposite direction is shown by the negative sign. So if you are talking about the magnitude, the speed or the recoil velocity of gun is 6 meters per second. Okay, understood this? So this is how we have to apply this law of conservation of momentum.